It's kind of like you can't even see it there. Well. Not this thingy, but it's on this thingy. So I kept this thingy so I could tell you what it's called. Hey guys, welcome back. So got Friday Favorites and Fooey's for you today, and this was kind of like a girly sort of a week. Like, that's why I put on the kind of pinky sort of a shirt. I was into kind of pinks and neutrals and reds, so just very like girly looks this week. So that's what the favorites are, all kind of under that category. Yes, so let's get to it. For my eye looks this week, again, I was busy with work and had some meetings and things, so I was pretty much going pretty neutral with my eye looks, and I pretty much wore this almost every single day. This is the BH Cosmetics Wild Child palette. I am gonna be doing a video kind of comparing all of my BH Cosmetics baked products, so you can kind of like see the different palettes and listen to my thoughts and whatever. So yeah, this is the one that I wore this week, and it's just a beautiful neutral palette. Today I'm wearing this color and this color and this color on my eyes, but I mean also like these sort of like bronzy kind of colors, like the neutral browns are just super easy for kind of like those one shadow type looks. I feel like looking in the monitor, my blush is a little bit crazy today. So if my blush is, whoa, kind of out there, it's kind of out there. I guess it just is. It is what it is. So yeah, I love this palette. I've mentioned this before, how I use these baked shadows. I usually foil them and apply them wet with some MAC Fix Plus on my lids, and then I kind of blend them up dry in my crease and outer corner, and then I do have my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer in my crease. That's just like I grab that a lot if I'm just needing a crease color. So yeah, just really pretty baked shadows. I love them. I think they're nice, and I think these palettes are like $8 usually. Well, it kind of depends on the sale that they have going, but around $8 to $10. So super affordable, really pretty neutral palette, cute packaging, just makes me smile and makes some pretty eye looks. On my cheeks this week, this is kind of a surprise favorite. This is Benefit's Benetint, and I really like overall haven't been a fan of these just because I feel like they're a little bit more high maintenance to get like blended just right. And especially this one, because this is scary. I mean, it's like red. So you gotta move quick with this. It is a stain. I will show you a swatch, but I gotta wipe this off quick because otherwise it's going to be there forever. So there it is, just quickly swatched. And then when you blend, it's kind of like you can't even see it there. But it's on my cheeks. It's just a really pretty like red, and it's very kind of rosy colored. So I think I really just was surprised by it because I think it sort of creates that kind of natural kind of makeup look, because it makes you look like you're naturally flushed, especially if you just get just a little bit of it. What I do is I put it on my small stipple brush, I kind of wipe it across that, and then I kind of buff it in or dot it in. So kind of what I do is sort of like stamp it on and then blend like this. So Keep it moving, because otherwise it'll stick. But once you get it on there, like if you get the kind of like application technique down, it stays. I mean, it's a stain, and it just has that kind of like natural flushed look. So I feel like it kind of has that more natural makeup look. I mean, I went a little ham with it today, and I put something over it, so I'm not quite as natural today, but it can have that look if you don't go crazy with it like I did. But I just have a little one. I got this in a little set. And I like it. I mean, you can use this on your lips too. I feel like I can't get it really even on my lips, but for my cheeks, I'm learning how to apply it better, and I am liking it a lot. I also pulled this one out this week and really enjoyed it. This is one of those kind of like overlooked sort of drugstore products. I know I overlooked it for a really long time, but once I bought it, I was really impressed with it. I think it's so pretty. This is the L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Blush, and this is in C12 Baby Blossom. And it's just a really pretty, sweet pink. And it's one of those, like, it is pigmented. I mean, it definitely has pigmentation to it, but if you just apply like a light layer of it, it's not over the top, but you can build it up and really get like a beautiful girly cheek. I'm gonna try to show you like a light application and then a little bit built up, so you can kind of, they kind of look the same, but well, maybe they don't, I don't know, but they look pretty close. So this is a light application and this is applying a little bit more. So you can see, I mean, you really can kind of take it up a notch, and I just think it's so pretty. And I don't know about you, but I know that I walked by these for a really long time before I finally got them. They're kind of pricey, to be honest, for a drugstore item. I want to say they're like $12 or $13, which that is pricey. But this is a big blush. You get 6 grams. So, I mean, it is a big size and it's just pretty. I have this one and some other peachy color. I don't know the name of it, but I like that one too. So if you've overlooked this blush a lot, Baby Blossom, I would say give it a go. For lips this week, I have another drugstore product that's been around for a really long time. This is one of the Revlon Just Bitten Kissable Balm Stains, and this is in Darling. And it's a really pretty, like, purpley pink color. I feel like I thought this was more purpley, but once I got it on my lips, it really shows up, at least on me, more kind of like pinky with a little hint of purple. And after it stains, it definitely goes more pink. So I feel like it's just so cute, so girly, wears pretty well. Not like, I don't know, for saying a stain, it doesn't wear crazy well. This is what I'll say. The actual product doesn't stick around for a super long time, but the stain is there. So yeah, so you might not have this kind of like more purpley look to your lips left, but you might have that kind of pinky stain. So yeah, I just think it's fun. I like the packaging, I think it's cute. I like these kind of like lip pencil things. I think that they are fun and easy. And this is like a minty sort of a scent. So that's a little added bonus to it. This one kind of veers off the path of a girly, pinky red sort of a favorite, but I really liked it this week. I did wear it one day and I think it's fun. I think it's pretty. I think it's kind of edgy. This is the Balm's Meet Matte Hues Long Lasting Liquid Lipstick, and this is in Charming. And it's just kind of like a 90s kind of a color. I mean, it's a brown. These smell yummy. Oh my gosh, like a mint chocolate cookie, like a thin mint, like a Girl Scout thin mint yummy scent situation. So they smell yummy, and this color is just really pretty. It's like a kind of a warm toned brown, so it has sort of like a rusty vibe to it, a little bit of a, like a terracotta vibe to it. I really do like the formula on these. I feel like they are long wearing, not nearly as uncomfortable as most liquid lipsticks. They do kind of do the they're not there sort of a thing, but they're really long wearing. So because they're not as uncomfortable, I like them better. Yeah, in a nutshell, yes. So this one's really pretty. I have this one and I think it's called Committed, something like that. It's kind of like a light peachy nude. I really like that one too, but that one's a little tiny baby one that I got in like Ipsy or something. And this is actually the full size. So I really do enjoy this. And lastly, I need to film another haul video because I've been picking up things just kind of here and there. So this is one of the things that I've picked up here and there. This is one of the Stila Stay All Day Magnificent lipsticks. These are new. This is in the color Soiree. Doesn't say the actual, it says the color name, but not the like lipstick name on the thingy. So not this thingy, but it's on this thingy. So I kept this thingy so I could tell you what it's called. So yeah, the Magnificent lipstick in Soiree. This is what I'm wearing and I like this. This isn't the color that I was expecting because it was described as like, I think like a fuchsia pink. That looks like a red to me, like a pinky sort of a red. I don't know. I mean, I looked it up again. I'm pretty sure it said that this was a pink. So I don't know. I would call that a red, but I think it's really, really pretty. It's a really comfortable matte lipstick, like kind of feels like, sort of reminds me of the Maybelline Creamy Mattes a little bit, but not exact, but it still has that sort of comfortable feel on the lips. But look at that pigmentation, so pretty, love this color. I was reading reviews of like what other people thought about these. Well, one thing I will note, the packaging feels, it looks pretty, but it feels kind of light and cheapy. So don't like that about it. I think this was around $21. So a little bit on the pricier side, but it's not like a $30 lipstick. So other people that were saying that they didn't think these were very long wearing and they were kind of wearing off unevenly, I was pretty impressed with wear time on it. I thought it wore pretty well. Through a meal, like I did have some left. It depended on the meal. One meal, I had most all of it left. Another meal, a lot of it had kind of worn away. Sort of like, not quite as well as the Urban Decay comfort mats. So not as long wearing through a meal like those, but pretty long wearing. So I like it. And especially like if you're not eating, it stuck around on my lips and I think it's really comfortable. I think it's a really pretty color. Packaging looks pretty. It just feels a little bit cheap, but I especially love this color. I think I would have liked a pink, but because that's what I was going for, but I like whatever this is too. All right guys, so those are all my favorites for this week. So I hope that you really enjoyed this video. Please hit a thumbs up if you did and let me know down below what you were loving this week or maybe not so much loving. Let me know your weekend plans or any questions that you have. I'm happy to answer those. Please subscribe to my channel if you're not already and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.